Hello, welcome to PushCorp. I'm Isaiah Flora. In today's video, we explore recycling insulated glass units. Let's jump in. As we walk through this robotic material removal process, please leave a comment with any questions you have and we'll do our best to get you an answer. Please like and subscribe to keep up with all the different applications coming through the lab. And as always, if you want to skip ahead to the application video, just hit that chapter below. Global engineering firm Arup approached us as they wanted to find a way to increase the volume of glass that could be recycled from window panes when they are removed from buildings. They estimate by cleaning up the glass and recycling instead of going into a landfill, for every ton of glass that's recycled, 300 kilograms of CO2 emissions could be saved. So they arranged for Saint-Gobain Glass to send us insulated glass units, or IGUs, to the PushCorp demo lab, and we teamed up to see if we could find a solution. IGUs are made up of two glass panes, sandwiching an aluminum spacer, and held together by rubbery sealants. Our goal was to separate the glass panes, then remove the spacer and sealants, all without damaging the glass. This would enable glass panes to be recovered and recycled when old buildings are demolished. To achieve this, we use a PushCorp STC0605BT30 spindle. It's a servo-driven, 6-horsepower, 5,000 RPM spindle motor with an automatic BT30 tool changer. We chose this motor due to the speeds we wanted to spin the media and cutter, and for its high torque that enables it to maintain a constant speed while in contact with the part. We paired that spindle with a PushCorp AFD72. It's a passive unit with a max force of 50 pounds. We use the same orientation through the whole process, making it a great fit for passive compliance. If an end user decided they wanted to articulate to multiple sides of the part, or if we needed to follow a complex curved part, then an active compliance unit such as PushCorp's AFD310 would be the preferred choice. PushCorp's AFD310 has the same form factor as the AFD72, but internal sensors allow it to compensate for orientation changes in real time, allowing you to apply a constant force through your whole motion. In the video, you can see we use two orientations when mounting the spindle onto the compliance device. Both of these configurations allow you to apply a radial compliant force, but offer separate benefits. The perpendicular configuration allows for further reach and easy articulation around joint 6. The parallel configuration provides extra rigidity and less of a moment arm from joint 6. Either of these configurations will be able to handle all the process steps in this demo. The end user will choose the configuration that best fits their application. However, both configurations are shown in the video to display what options are available. The last piece of this application is the abrasives and cutter we put on the spindle. We started off with a 7-inch diameter 3M Cubitron 2 cutoff wheel. This cut through both the gasket material and the aluminum spacer, splitting the IGU in half. Then we attached a 1/2-inch end mill to remove the aluminum spacer. Lastly, we used two wheels to remove the gasket material. First was a 3M multi-finish wheel. Its high conformability and moderate aggressiveness allowed us to strip off the gasket material without damaging the glass panel. Then we followed it up with a 3M EXL Pro Deburring Wheel to refine the scratch pattern on the glass. Depending on the end user's finish requirements, they may be able to skip the EXL Pro Deburring Wheel altogether. All right, that's all the details we have for you. Here's the application video. Using a 3M cutoff wheel, the first step was to slice through the outer sealant and metal spacer. Off camera, we repositioned the block to repeat this step on all four sides. This process took the original IGU and separated it into two glass panes with residual sealant material and aluminum spacer on each pane. We addressed removing the aluminum spacer with a 1/2-inch end mill. We laid the glass pane on a flat surface, putting it into a repeatable position. We could then position the end mill just above the pane to remove the aluminum spacer. Once again, we repositioned the pane to repeat the process on each side. With the only sealant remaining on the pane, we use 3M's multi-finish wheel to complete the glass clean. This left a slight scratch pattern on the parent material that we refined with a 3M EXL Pro Deburring Wheel. Now the glass pane is ready to be reused, significantly extending its life cycle. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see your parts in the demo lab or have interest in our equipment, send an email to sales@pushcorp.com. Want more automated polishing inspirations? Check out our linked polishing playlist. That's all for this one. We'll see you next time.